Hello everyone. In this video, I'll guide you through the process of configuring SNMP v3 on a Cisco CBS350 switch using the Web GUI. SNMP v3 is a more secure version of the SNMP protocol compared to v1 and v2, providing enhanced security for your network. First, open your web browser and go to the IP address of your Cisco CBS350 switch. Then, log in using your admin account to access the Web GUI for configuration. After logging in, we'll switch to Advanced Mode. This mode will show all the advanced configuration options, including SNMP v3, which we're about to set up. Okay, once we're in advanced mode, take a look at the menu on the left and click on the Security tab. After opening the Security tab, scroll down, then look for TCP UDP Services and click on it. In the TCP UDP Services section, make sure the SNMP service option is selected. Then, click the Apply button to save the configuration. Alright, next, from the left-hand menu, scroll all the way down and select the SNMP tab. In the Engine ID section, select Use Default. This is the device's default value used to uniquely identify the SNMP engine. Then, click Apply to save the changes. Next, click on the Group tab so we can create a user group for SNMP v3. Now, click the plus icon to create a new group. In the Group Name field, enter the name of the group you want. You can name it whatever you like. Just make sure it's easy to remember and fits its purpose. In the Security Model section, select SNMP v3. Next, click on Authentication and Privacy under the Access Mode section. This is the highest security level in SNMP v3. It authenticates users and encrypts the data. Additionally, you can also select Write or Notify if you want to give the group write access or enable notifications. All right. You've successfully created the group. Next, click on the User tab to create a user for SNMP v3. All right, click the plus icon on the right to add a new user. In the Username field, enter the username you want. This will be used for authentication when an SNMP device connects. For the Engine ID option, just leave it as the default local. In the Group Name section, select the group you created earlier. This links the user to the correct access permission set by that group. Next, under Authentication Method, select SHA-256. Next, enter the authentication password in the field below. Make sure to use a strong password to keep your SNMP v3 connection secure. Next, under Privacy Method, select AES. This encryption algorithm helps protect your data during transmission. And finally, you'll also need to set a password for the encryption. This password is used to encrypt SNMP data, so make sure it's strong as well. Finally, click Apply to save the SNMP v3 user configuration we've just created. So now you've successfully created the SNMP v3 user with both authentication and encryption. Finally, click the Save button at the top to save all the configuration to the system. This ensures that your SNMP v3 settings will be retained even after the device restarts. And that's it. See you in the next videos, and don't forget to subscribe, like, and share to support the channel.